Welcome back to Get More Math. In this video, we are going to talk about how to draw graphs in Get More Math. We'll look at number lines, coordinate planes, word problems, and inequalities. First, let's look at how to plot a point. Plotting a point on a number line is simple. I'm just going to click on 0.19, which is where I want my point. That looks a little off, so I can use the arrow buttons to adjust my point's location, or I can click on the trash can to delete it and try again. When I'm happy with the location of my point, I click on the green check and the point turns blue. If you realize that your point is in the wrong place after you click on the green check, you can click on the trash can below the number line to delete it, or you can click on the point again, it'll turn pink and you can keep adjusting it. Also, keep in mind that clicking on the green check in the adjustment box doesn't submit your problem. When you're ready to submit, click on the green check button below the number line. Plotting a point on a coordinate plane is about the same deal. Again, you can use the arrows to adjust the location of your point, or use the trash can to delete it, and you can click on the green check when you're done. If you're graphing on your phone or another small screen, just notice that the arrows and trash can are on top of the graph instead of being next to it. So let's move on and graph some lines. To graph a line, you just need to plot two points in the same way that we just did, and Get More Math will draw the line between them. If you make a mistake, notice that there are two different trash cans here. The trash can below the graph deletes everything, but the trash can on the right is only for the point that you just drew. So let's say that I plot two points, but then realize that I put the second point in the wrong place. I can use the trash can on the right to delete just that wrong point. You can see that the first point I drew is still there, it didn't get deleted. But if I graph a point, click on the green check, and then realize that it's in the wrong place, the trash can on the right is gone. I can't delete just that point anymore. Instead, I have to use the trash can below the graph to delete everything. So here we have a word problem, and there's a few things that we need to know how to do in order to graph it successfully. First, since it's a word problem, I need to give this graph labels. To do this, I'm clicking on the Settings button below the graph. From the graph settings, you can change the labels and the scale of your graph for both the X and Y axes. Let's start by using the top menus to select the correct units to use for labeling each of the axes. So X is hours and Y is quects. Alright, now I just need to graph the points on my table, 0,264 and 44,0. But there's an issue. This graph only goes up to about 12.5 in either direction. It's too small for me to graph these points. To fix this, I'm going to go back into the graph settings that we just saw, and this time I'll use the bottom menus to change the scale of my graph. I'll set my X scale to 5 and my Y scale to 50. Now the graph goes far enough for me to plot my points. But be careful when you change the scale of your graph, because a very large scale makes it difficult to put your points in the exact right places. Going back to our word problem, by default, Get More Math usually gives you a line when you graph. But in the situation in this problem, that doesn't even make sense. A line extends infinitely in both directions, but you can't have negative hours or negative quects. So instead I'll switch to using a segment by using the drop-down menu above the graph. When graphing a segment, first select the point where it begins, and then the point where it ends. In the same menu, you can find everything that you will ever need to graph in Get More Math. To graph a ray, first select the point where it begins, then another point somewhere along its path. To graph a parabola, first select its vertex, then a second point, anywhere else on the parabola. Get More Math will take care of the rest. Alright, now let's talk about graphing inequalities. Here we have an inequality on a number line, and the first thing that I'm going to do is open up the menu to decide whether to use an empty circle or a filled circle as the starting point for my ray. All that this menu is for is choosing whether you want an empty circle or a filled circle. Even though the pictures of the rays on this menu are all pointing in the same direction, you can actually graph them pointing either way. So let's go ahead and graph this. The mark in the middle of the number line is 0, so negative 4 is here. This is where the ray begins. Now I'm just clicking somewhere to the right of that point so that my ray goes in the correct direction. Next, let's graph a compound inequality. When I solve this inequality, Get More Math automatically puts the values onto the number line, but I still need to make sure that they're in the right order, with the smaller value on the left. If you need to switch the order of your values, all you need to do is press the arrow button between the two boxes. Now I'll use the menu to find the right type of segment to draw between these two points. If you ever need to switch between one and two points on your number line, click on the button to the right of the menu. When graphing inequalities on a coordinate plane, first graph the equation that you're given as usual. Then you'll need to decide whether to use a solid line or a dotted line. You can switch between solid and dotted by clicking on the box above the graph on the right. Wait until you've finished graphing all of your lines before you shade your graph. To shade a portion of a graph, click on the menu, select Shade, and then just click anywhere in the area that needs to be shaded. Well, that's all for this video about graphing in GMM. Thanks for watching!